Master, we give you adoration, everlasting King, we magnify you. You are welcome, O God Almighty, into this sanctuary tonight. We yield our spirits unto you, we yield our beings unto you. We empty ourselves before thy presence tonight. We came longing for thee. We came thirsty for thee, O God. This night we came hungry for thee, Master. So pour yourself into us, everlasting Lord. Fill us afresh individually and corporately. Let your hand therefore come upon us individually tonight. I pray in Jesus' name that you will visit us. I pray in Jesus' name that you will visit us. I pray in the mighty name of Jesus Christ that you will visit us. Visit us individually, my Father. Just as our faces are different, O God Almighty, from each other, so are our needs and our concerns. But I pray tonight in the mighty name of Jesus Christ that thou that made the heavens and the earth will break forth upon us individually tonight. Answer somebody's question in this place, my Father. Touch somebody's life this night in Jesus' name. Heal somebody in this place, everlasting Savior. And comfortably speak unto your children, my God. Edify us, my Father. Edify us tonight by thy presence and by thy word. I come against the wickedness of the enemy tonight. I bind the lies of the devil tonight. I curse the lies of the adversary tonight. Whatever the arrangement of the enemy is against any soul tonight, Lord, I destroy it in Jesus' name. I call for thy mercy. 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 Visit us, O God, in thy mercy and in thy power. Visit us tonight in thy mercy and in thy power. Let thy glory fall upon us tonight in the name of Jesus Christ. Mighty Savior, we worship you. Mighty Savior, we bless you. Mighty Savior, we honor you. Thank you so much for your presence. Thank you so much for your anointing. Thank you so much for your great spirit. Thank you so much for thy counsel. And thank you so much for thy voice. I give you glory tonight. I give you praise tonight. And I say thank you, my dear King. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. 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 Come on, someone give the Lord a big clap tonight. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus, and you may be seated in his presence tonight. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory be to God forevermore. I take this opportunity to welcome our friends watching us live on Facebook tonight. You are all welcome to the Word in Action Church here in the city of Houston, in the wonderful state of Texas. Welcome, everybody, and God bless you tonight for tuning in. Invite your friends and call them and tell them that Word in Action is live. Let them tune in and get a word to bless them tonight in the name of Jesus Christ. If you all can, please, let's turn our Bibles to the book of Psalm, Psalm 23. Psalm 23. That is what we've been studying for the past few weeks. Amen. And we've been enjoying it, and God has been speaking to us through this wonderful psalm written by the man of God called David. Hallelujah. And as we have explained in previous sessions, this psalm actually is David's testimony. His testimony, he's talking about the accomplishments of God in his life, and he's talking about the results of his relationship with God Almighty. For when you have intimate relationship with God, it has results. He has not asked us to worship him in vain. Hallelujah. Our relationship with God has results. It bears fruit. Amen. So look for it. But let's read Psalm 23 verse 1. And it says, the Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the path, in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yes, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. 5. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointed my head with oil, and my cup runneth over. 6. Surely Goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. May the Lord bless the reading of his word. So David says, the Lord Jehovah is his shepherd, and as a result of that, he has no want. When God Almighty is in charge of your life, and he controls your life, that is what a shepherd is. He controls your life. You turn your life over to him. And you say, my father, I have not done a good job controlling my life. I realize my inadequacy. I realize my shortcoming. I realize that I cannot do it without you. I have understood that I am only mortal and I can only do so much. So I turn my life over to you. And I ask that you be in charge of my life. And the Bible says, when God is in charge of your life, then you have no want. Because his presence in your life ensures that every need and every want in your life is attended to. As I had mentioned earlier, it is not an empty relationship. The Bible says, you mark the upright man. The end of that man is peace. When all is said and done, the word of God shall be vindicated in your life. That which you have believed regarding God shall be vindicated. It shall come to pass. Hallelujah. Because God is faithful. The promises of God regarding your life, the Bible says, they are yea and in him amen. Hallelujah. It comes to pass. The scriptures tell us that heaven and earth will pass away, but not an iota of his word shall go unfulfilled. So indeed, a man can actually base his life upon the word of the Lord. Hallelujah. And it comes to pass. Hallelujah. So it's not an empty relationship. If you've walked with God, if you've served him, you know for sure that that which I'm talking about is true. Because there'll be many times in your life when you'll be confronted with need and challenges. And out of nowhere will emerge deliverance and salvation. For that is who he is. And he goes on to say that he makes me to lie down in green pastures and he leads me beside the still waters. And as we have mentioned in times past, that the sheep actually needs to be led. If you are sheep, expect to be led by the shepherd. Unless you are goat. If you have problem with leadership, hallelujah. If you have problem with God leading you, then you might be a goat, hallelujah. You are rebellious. You are full of yourself. You are arrogant. But you see, a man must come to that place in their lives and realize that, you know what? My strength cannot get this done. I know these days we've got motivational speakers that inspire us and encourage us and thank God for their lives. And they almost make you feel invincible until you get hit with a headache that will not respond to Tylenol. And then you realize that, man, you are just human. Hallelujah. Yes, we are. Glory be to God forevermore. And I pray in Jesus' name that don't allow situations to bring you to your knees. Don't allow issues to force you to bow before God. Hallelujah. Understand that you need him, and you take that step and bow. One way or the other, you go bow. You either you bow today or you go bow later. One day you go bow. The Bible says every knee, hallelujah, shall bow. So one day you go bow, hallelujah. You either bow now or you go bow later. But a man needs God. A man needs God to lead him or her. Don't think you got all the answers. It doesn't matter your academic background. It doesn't matter your financial state, as wonderful and as secure as you may feel. Only one thing can walk into your life and reduce you to nothing. We were all here minding our own business, and then we heard that there is a virus that's breaking out in China. And everybody thought China is very far away. And then we are realizing that as human beings, we are connected. Hallelujah. And this virus found its way into our homes, into our nation, into our country. And it's become a big issue. The sad part is that it is an invisible enemy. So you can't fight it. It's very difficult to attend to an invisible enemy. But that tells us that we are only human. And we must depend on God. And trust him. And rely on his message by day and by night. And solicit his help. Let's invite him into our lives. Let's come up and say, Father, we can't do this by ourselves. So come on in, hallelujah. A sheep must be led. Submit yourself.
Oh, humble yourself, therefore, under the mighty hand of God, hallelujah, that he may exalt you in due season. Glory to God. God is able to lift you up if only you bow before him. Tonight is the night to bow. Sometimes you walk around and we brag and we are arrogant and we are very cocky and proud, hallelujah. But you are only human. You are only human, hallelujah. This one event can change your life forevermore. Bow before God. So he says, he restored my soul. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. So the refreshing that you need comes from the presence of God. The refreshing that you need comes from the presence of God. So as you walk with God, hallelujah, your youthfulness is renewed as that of the eagles. You are refreshed. You go to sleep at night and you wake up refreshed. Now you can go to sleep, but it doesn't mean that you wake up refreshed. There are people that actually go to bed, but they can't sleep. There are others also that sleep, but they don't wake up rested. Because even in your sleep, it's a battle all night long. Some of you, every night, you are in constant battle in dreams. Hallelujah. You are fighting every night. Every night there is a horrible thing that is happening to you by reason of your dreams. Consistently, to the point where you are used to it. So when you wake up in the morning, you are tired and you are weak and it ruins your day. There are people watching me even tonight. There are some specific dreams when you have, you have even noticed that when you have this specific dream, you're going to have a bad day. Tonight, I speak to you in the name of Jesus Christ, that if you allow God Almighty into your life, hallelujah, that will also cease. For the Bible says he gives his beloved sleep, hallelujah, that the rest of God shall come upon you. He says, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. If you are lying, he will bring you rest. And now you will lay down and you'll be able to sleep and you'll be rested. You wake up in the morning refreshed. And you're going to have sweet dreams about God and about heaven. You're not going to be dreaming about demons and somebody trying to kill you, somebody trying to do ugly things to you. You are not going to have those dreams anymore. Hallelujah. Because there's a new shepherd in town. Amen. Give God a chance. Give God a chance. Give God a chance. Hallelujah. Give God a chance. There are some of you listening to me tonight. Every night, your house turns into a zoo. Because you have all kinds of dreams. Today is a tiger. You're going to be dreaming about a tiger roaming around in your room. And you can describe a tiger very well. Tomorrow is a lion. The next day is an alligator that came to hide under your bed. Every day there's a wild animal that is trying to harass you in your dreams. And you wake up tired. You wake up worn out. You are drained before you even step out. There's the devil at work. It is sin that comes to steal, to kill, and to destroy. But Jesus Christ has come so you have life and have it in abundance. Hallelujah. Invite him into your life. Welcome him in. Let the glory of God encamp around your dwelling. Hallelujah. And let the angels encamp around your dwelling. And let God's glory fill your house. Amen. Amen. That is how you flourish. So yes, God is in the business of refreshing us. After a long day, hallelujah, when everything went wrong and you feel tired, all you need to do is just lift up your voice and begin to call upon and say, my Father, you are all that I have and you are not all that I need. Oh man, I am tired, I am worn out. Can you please refresh me? Can you please touch me and refresh me? And you know what? He will stretch out his hands from heaven and he will lay it upon you. And all of a sudden, mentally, you become refreshed. Like a cloud will come over you. A cloud of cold water will come over you. And you'll be refreshed. And then your strength will return. And your joy shall return. Hallelujah. And that depression will leave you. Because you'll be refreshed by the presence of God. People of God, David, hallelujah, told us this testimony to encourage us. To let us understand that walking with God has benefits. Working with God has benefits. Minus that presence, minus that anointing, minus that glory, you cannot go very far. Today, many people's problem is anxiety. Anxious and a tremendous stress. Sometimes you see people driving and you could tell that they are so much stressed out. Every little thing sets them off. That's why God, all this these people fighting on the freeway all the time because they are tired already. And this is very early in the morning, 7:45. But all night long, they've been battling. They've been battling on their bed. They've been battling. They've been so stressed out in their dreams and in their sleep. So they were never refreshed. And they wake up in the morning and they got to go all over again. Why do you think people keep dropping dead? Because they are tired. They are worn out. But Jesus Christ refreshes us. He comes into your life, hallelujah, and he refreshes you. He gives you answers when you need it. Before the questions will arise in your life, he has already provided the answers for you, beloved. It pays to serve God. It pays to walk with God. It pays to serve the Lord Jesus Christ in our generation. I don't care what anybody says or thinks about God or my ask for me. I have experienced his generosity. I did not build for him. Where would we be? Where would we be? I encourage you tonight, don't allow circumstances to force you to bow. Bow on your own. Invite him into your life. Serve him with all of your heart. Everything that you are, place it before God. Honor God with your life. And give God the opportunity to bless you. David was a nobody. He was a nobody. He was a little boy in his own house. He meant nothing to them. When everybody was at home, he was dispatched to go into the wilderness to go and take care of sheep. He was the least among his family members. That is why you see his story matters to us. Because there are some of us, hallelujah, that speaks to our background. And God says, you know what? I have found my servant David. And with my holy oil have I anointed him. When God found him, hallelujah, in spite of his background, he placed his anointing upon him. And when the anointing of God came upon the guy, hallelujah, he became a giant killer, hallelujah. He became a terror to the enemies of the people of God. Because there's transformation. So when he says, the Lord is my shepherd, and I have no one to pay attention, hallelujah. Oh yes, we pay attention. Because we see a man that was picked up from nothing. And God made something fantastic out of his life. This is why we serve the Lord. Serve God Almighty. Be faithful to God. Honor him privately and publicly. Serve Jesus Christ. Let your life matter to God. Bless folks. Be an inspiration to others. Don't just live and die serving yourself. Don't be a self-worshipper. Be a worshipper of the great I am. Turn your life loose unto you. Say, my Father, I yield. Have your way in me. And see what God Almighty will do with you. Hallelujah be to Jesus. Hallelujah be to Jesus. Let's continue to read. So he refreshes us. Hallelujah. He says he leads us in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Verse 4 says, yes, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Ah, hallelujah. Glory be to God forevermore. And it says, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, and I explain to you that the valley of the shadow of death, hallelujah, actually was a place that existed. And it was a place that was dark, and wild beasts roamed free. And people had to pass through that place. And when you get over there, the chances are you ain't coming out of that forest. So when he said, no, I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, hallelujah, glory be to God. He knew what he was talking about. But some of you listening to me tonight, you feel like you are in the valley of the shadow of death. Because they told you, you can't make it. Some of you listening to me, you may even be in a hospital, and they are saying that you won't live through the night. But I speak to you under the anointing of the Holy Ghost. You're only passing through the valley of the shadow of death. That is not your final destination. There's a place that God is taking you. Hallelujah. God is taking you somewhere. Where you are today is just a transient place. Hallelujah. You are only passing through. You are only passing through. You have not arrived yet. Amen. Glory to God. So come on, cheer up tonight. Hallelujah. Be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. He says, I will not be afraid. I know where I am. I will not be afraid. And I'm not denying that I'm in the valley of the shadow of death. I ain't denying it, but I won't be afraid. I will not be afraid because he said, I come with you. He said, I come with you. Child of God, it doesn't matter how you are feeling this evening. God stands right there with you. It doesn't matter how much money you have in your bank account or you don't have in your bank account. God Almighty still stands with you. It doesn't matter how much food you have in your pantry. Hallelujah. It may be empty even tonight, but God Almighty still stands with you. You are only passing through. The Bible says, weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. So somebody tonight, stand strong. Hallelujah. God has great things planned for your life. There are marvelous things coming for you. Hallelujah. When David was going through the valley of the shadow of death, hallelujah, people might have looked at him and said, oh boy, it is over. It is finished. But it is not over until God says it is over. Hallelujah. So there is hope for you. Tonight there is hope for you. There are good things coming your way. There are wonderful things prepared for you. There is hope for you. Refuse to die. Refuse to die. Don't die. Hallelujah. Make up your mind. I will live. I will live. I will prosper. I will increase. I will flourish. And even during this time, I speak to you again in Jesus' name. That even during this time, you will see your greatest victory because God does not change. God has no change. God has no change. Even during this time, during this period when everybody is scared and terrified and they have reason to be because we are fighting an enemy that is invisible and there is no answer. But you know something? God has an answer. And I speak into your life tonight that if you believe God, that during this difficult time, during this horrifying moment, God Almighty will rise up on your behalf. He will perform a wonder. He will perform a miracle. He will open a door unto you that no man can shut. He will hold your hands and lead you through unfamiliar paths until he brings you into that expected place in your life. Child of God, this is the time that you will see your greatest victory to the glory and praise of God Almighty. So when all is said and done, all you can say that this can only be God. This can only be God. This can only be God. Be encouraged tonight. Be strengthened tonight. Don't be afraid. Remember the Bible says clearly in Zechariah that it is not by might, it is not by power, but by my spirit says the Lord. It is not by might, it is not by power, but by my spirit says the Lord. It is not by might, it is not by power, but by my spirit says the Lord. Somebody allow the spirit of God to have his way. Allow the spirit of God to have his way. Somebody bow out of the way, hallelujah, and allow the spirit of God to have his way in your life and see what God will perform and see what God will accomplish. We are only human. We are limited, but he is unlimited. He is unlimited. He is unlimited. We saw this young boy that, hallelujah, his own family wouldn't even bring him in when they're having important meetings. When they're talking about important things, David was not really part of the subject. When someone came to the house looking for a king, hallelujah, and he looked at everybody that looked like a king, and he said, is this all they have? They actually said yes. Because it was an afterthought. It didn't matter. His presence didn't make any difference. Maybe that is how you feel. You feel unwanted. When family members gather together, you feel unwanted. You don't feel profitable. You don't feel needed. Sometimes they deliberately slight you so that you go home broken and depressed. But tonight, God sent me to come and encourage you that he is able to take nothing and make something out of them. If you give him the chance, if you give him the opportunity, there are some of you listening to me tonight, even because of where you are and your financial state, your own spouse don't like you, hallelujah, and doesn't respect you. But tonight I speak to you in the name of Jesus, that if you will believe God, amen, there is greatness in you, and God will bring that greatness out, and your value shall be seen, and your value shall be discovered, and those who despise you, they are the same ones that will welcome you, by reason of the anointing of the Holy Ghost. Give God a chance. Give God a chance. So let's continue to read. I'm not even going to what I want to preach tonight. My God, I'm having such a great time. That's what the anointing of the Holy Ghost does. Because it's not about what I have to say. It is about what he wants to say. And there's somebody listening to me tonight that needs to hear what God is speaking tonight. Oh, this is the voice of God at work. This is the counsel of the Holy Spirit at work. That is why we listen to the word of the Lord. Hallelujah. Because he will speak to to you. Tonight he is speaking to somebody. Hey, don't be afraid. Don't be discouraged. It doesn't matter what they said concerning you. Hallelujah. God has a better report regarding your life. God has something special regarding your life. He says, I've loved you with an everlasting love, and with loving kindness have I drawn you unto myself. Hallelujah. Don't worry about who doesn't like you. God Almighty says, I love you. I love you. And if you were the only person here on earth, he was still going to come in and go to the cross for you. That is how special you are. Hallelujah. Tonight, recognize that you are special. Not before man, but before God. Don't worry about what human beings think about you. As for folks, amen, you can even trust what they say. If you are hungry for the affirmation of human beings, hallelujah, you don't know who God is. Look for the affirmation of God. The Bible says, if a man's ways please the Lord, even his enemies will be at peace with him. Go on. Settle the issue with God. Find a place in the heart of God and sit over there and then see what God will do with them that call themselves your enemies. Hallelujah. They will come looking for you. Now they don't have to tolerate you. They want and need your presence. Hallelujah. Because of the glory of God. Give God a chance tonight. 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 Don't go home meditating on the ugly things that people said about you. Don't go home meditating on the ugly things that people said about you. Don't pay attention to that. If they love you, wonderful. If they don't like you, wonderful also. It doesn't make a difference. It is what God thinks about you that matters. It is God, what God thinks about you that matters. And he says, hey, I know the thoughts that I think towards you. Hallelujah. They are thoughts of good and not of evil to bring you into an expected end. Hallelujah. He says, come on, child. I know what I think about you. Your boss may not like you. Your wife may not like you. Your husband may not respect you. Hallelujah. It doesn't matter. Your children may disregard you. It doesn't matter. Hallelujah. God says, hey, I know what I think towards you. I have my own thoughts regarding your life. They are thoughts of good and not of evil to bring you into an expected end. So tonight I said there is hope for you. There is hope for you. There is hope for you. Nobody can imagine what your tomorrow is going to be like. Nobody. He says, I have not seen nor ear heard. Neither has it entered into the heart of man what Jehovah has prepared for those who love him. That includes you. That includes me. They don't know what God has prepared for you. The devil does not even know what God has prepared for you. But we know it is good. For the Bible says, every good and every perfect gift comes from above, hallelujah, even from the Father of lights, with whom there is no variableness or a shadow of doubt. Hallelujah. The Bible says God is not a man that he should lie, nor the son of man that he should change his mind. For has he not spoken, and shall he not make it good? Hallelujah. Everything that God has spoken concerning your life, he is going to make it good. It shall come to pass. Only wait, amen, be patient. Wait upon the Lord. Wait upon the promises of God. Wait upon the agenda of the Holy Ghost regarding your life. In the end, it shall speak, and it shall not lie. When God is finished with you, hallelujah, you don't need to say a word. It is the enemy that will come in and say, hey, look at what God has done for her. It can only be God. It can only be God. Be encouraged tonight. Be strengthened tonight. Maybe this evening you looked at your bank account and it didn't look that great. And you began to wonder, what is tomorrow going to be like? Child of God, leave tomorrow unto the maker of tomorrow. His name is Yahweh. Tomorrow belongs to him. As for you, enjoy what he has done in your life today. Worship him right now. Serve him now. Commit yourself to him right now. Make your vows to him right now. What you do with God now will determine how your tomorrow is going to be like. Amen. What you do with God right now will determine what your tomorrow is going to be like. But if you keep living the same way, if you keep disregarding his word, if you keep disregarding his laws, if you keep disregarding his personality, and you expect something to change, nothing is going to change. But you change. when you change, everything around you will change. Your car will change. Your house will change. Even your family will change. Sometimes we blame people for nothing. Hallelujah. When their fault is ours. How can everybody around you be wrong except you? You are the only right person. Everybody's, the problem is everybody else except you. Your mother is wrong. Your father is wrong. Your brothers and sisters, they are all wrong. They don't understand it. Your wife also doesn't understand it. Your own children doesn't understand. And then you went to work, you came back home and say, this boss doesn't even understand. How on earth could anybody be wrong except you? The reason why you feel that way is because you got the wrong glasses on. Go to God Almighty, let me open your eyes. Then you will see what is wrong with you. And then that same God, he will fix you. And by the time you are coming out, you'll be radiant. You'll be shining. The people that avoided you, now they will see who you are and they will embrace you. You walk around and you talk to people ugly. You are nasty to people. You feel that human beings owe you something. Child of God, listen, nobody owes you anything. If somebody sees you and they say good morning, they say it because they wanted to say it. They don't have to. So everything anybody does for you, appreciate it. Thank them for it. Don't walk around demanding things from people. And you know you're supposed to be doing this for me. You're supposed to be doing this for me. Nobody is supposed to be doing nothing for you. You have to earn it. You have to earn it. So change. If you change, then everything around you will change. But if you don't change, everything remains the same. And your tomorrow will be just like yesterday. We don't even need to get into the spirit to prophesy that. Because you change nothing. If you do not change, nothing will change, but you change. When you change, hallelujah, even your physical appearance will change. And everything around you will change. And people will begin to see you for who you truly are. And the folks walking around, you know, I can't understand it. How can everybody be wrong? Think about it. How can everybody around you that loves you is wrong except you? How can nobody around you understand except you? Your wife doesn't understand. Your children doesn't understand. Your boss doesn't understand. Your friends don't understand. Child of God, the problem is not the world. The problem is you. Get help. Get help. Get help so that your true significance can come out. Because if you keep walking around the way you are walking around, you ain't going to go anywhere. Your tomorrow will be just like yesterday. Hallelujah. But you change today, it will transform your tomorrow. Glory be to God forevermore.
Amen.
Glory be to God forevermore.
Amen.
Glory be to God forevermore. Somebody give the Lord a mic now. Look at me. I came to preach, you know, about verse 6 tonight. I can't even get there anymore. I can't even get there. So he says, yeah, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. And he says, thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies, and thou anointest my head with oil, and my cup overflows. Hallelujah. Glory to God forevermore. Amen. There are some tables that God is going to prepare for you, but there's going to be some enemies around, folks. There have to be some enemies around. Because I've discovered over the years that the enemies can tell the story better than your friends. Your enemy can tell your testimony better than yourself. So God says, I prepare a table before you in the presence of your enemies. And you see, David was speaking from experience. Because there were many times, hallelujah, when his enemies gathered around him, and he actually thought that that would be the end of his life because of the number of the enemies and the situations and everything that broke out against him. So he actually thought, man, this might be the end. But to his amazement, instead of it being the end, it turns out to promote him. That is why he said, oh my God, you act Come and see what I have done for my daughter. Come and see what I have done for my son. Come and see the accomplishments of my daughter. This is what I do to them that believe me. This is what I do to them that believe me. May the Lord prepare a table before you in the presence of your enemies. Let them come from the north. Let them come from the south. Let them come from the east. Let them come from the west. Hallelujah. May they come and see you blessed. May they come and see you prosperous. Your enemies should never come and see you broke, flat, broke, and depressed, and tired, hallelujah, and rejected. No! That's not the plan of God. That is the will of your enemy. To see you reduced. And God says, I will never let it come to pass. He says, the will of your enemy, hallelujah, shall not materialize. But God's will for your life comes to pass. And he says, I, the Lord, I choose to prepare a table before you in the presence of your enemies, not in the absence of your enemies. God is not going to do it behind your enemies. No. They must see it. They must see it. Hallelujah. They must see it. They must see it. Child of God. They must see it. The sister listening to me tonight, they said you will never have a child. They said you'll be buried forever. But guess what? God has a surprise for them. They're going to see you in the mall. And you're going to be wheeling your daughter, hallelujah, in the stroller. Glory to God forevermore. Hallelujah. And they're going to see you carrying the car seat. And they'll say, what do you have in there? They say, hey, the Lord bless me with a lovely girl. Hallelujah. They say, well, you can. That's right. Me. That is what it means when God is preparing the table before you in the presence of your enemies. He said it will never happen. They even made a song about you. Wicked people. They have a song. You just don't know it. So when you show up, they begin to sing a song. And you think they are singing something from the radio. No, this is a very sarcastic song for you. Describing your condition that can never change. But they don't know the God that you serve. Hallelujah. They don't know the God that you serve. They have not encountered the God that you serve. He actually prepares a table before thee in the presence of your enemies. So let them come. Let them come. Whoever decides to rise up against you and set himself up against you, don't worry about them. Don't ever go worrying about who doesn't like you. Don't ever worry about them. Don't ever go home, hallelujah, worrying about who doesn't like you, who is waiting for you to fall. Don't ever worry about that. The Bible says for the righteous man, they will fall 7 times, but they will rise up 7 times, hallelujah. When you see any righteous man, you better be concerned, amen, because this man ain't going down, hallelujah. It doesn't matter how much you beat them down, the righteous man is not going down. The Bible says he has provided and made provision for him to rise up again. You rise up again. You rise up again. You rise up again. You rise up again. Maybe this pandemic, hallelujah, has reduced your business. But I speak to you in Jesus' name. It will spring back up, hallelujah. You rise up again, hallelujah. Maybe this pandemic has affected you financially. In the name of Jesus Christ, I speak to you tonight. That guess what? You shall prosper again. You shall flourish again. You shall increase again. For the righteous man will fall 7 times, but they will rise up 7 times. That is what God can do. That is what God, and if you believe, that is your portion. Tonight be encouraged. Tonight be strengthened. May hope rise up in you. May your faith rise up. God has not left us. He has not abandoned us. He walks with us. When the word of the Lord said that he will never leave us nor forsake us, he meant it. The Bible goes on to say that we may boldly say that Jehovah is our helper. He means it. He means to walk with you. Tonight be encouraged and believe that God walks with you. And because he walks with you, it shall be well with you. David said, I have been young and now I am old. I have never seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging for bread. Hallelujah. That is the portion of the righteous. He said, I have never seen the righteous forsaken, nor the seed of the righteous begging for bread. It doesn't matter. It may be a pandemic, but the righteous will never beg for bread. Hallelujah. If David didn't see it, he said he was once upon a time young, and now he grew. So he has experience. He said, this thing, I have never seen it. Hallelujah. And it shall not be your portion. Because God Almighty will find a way to rescue you. Unto the upright, there arises light in darkness. Unto the upright,
there arises light in darkness. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in times of trouble. Therefore, we will not be afraid. Though the earth be removed and the mountains be carried into the sea, and the waters thereof roar with the swelling thereof, hallelujah. Oh, there is a fountain, hallelujah. It is the fountain of God that rises up in the midst of trouble to rescue, to sustain, and to preserve the people of God. The Bible says there is a stream. Its waters makes the people of God glad. You will be glad even at this time. You will laugh even at this time. Even at this time, you will have opportunity to jubilate and to celebrate the faithfulness of your God. Child of God, the Lord bless you tonight. The Lord bless you tonight. The Lord bless you tonight. The Spirit of God make a way for you tonight. God Almighty Himself make a way for you tonight. The Lord Himself bless you tonight in the name of Jesus Christ. I'm going to end this service tonight. There are some of you listening to me. The word that you have heard tonight has encouraged you. Let's stand you up. And you're asking yourself, what shall I do to be saved? Very good question. Very good time. All you have to do is to believe in your heart that Jesus Christ is the Son of God. And He died for you on the cross and received Him into your life as your Lord and your personal Savior. If that is what you want to do tonight, say this prayer after me. Say, Lord Jesus, I acknowledge my sin. I realize tonight that I have walked away from you and I've lived to please myself. But tonight, I turn my life over to you. I invite you to come into my life. Be my Lord and my personal Savior. Write my name in the Lamb's Book of Life. And if I should die tonight, I will spend eternity with you. Satan, walk away from me. For I have nothing to do with you from tonight. Every contract, every covenant is broken. I belong to Jesus. And from today onwards, Him only will I serve. If you said this prayer with me, I want you to know tonight that you are saved. And indeed, your name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life. And eternity awaits you in the presence of God. Because we serve a very faithful God. God bless all of you by Facebook. Hallelujah. Go on. Prosper. Increase. Flourish. Do wonders for your God and bless your brother in the name of Jesus Christ. God bless you. Amen.